Punch her. But he just shot his fist at her.
Welcome back, everybody, to episode 12 of this Let's Play of Legend of Keepers. We're playing as Serral the Enchantress, and we are retrying mission 4 since we died trying it on the first go-around. We died to a bard killed us, which is maybe the most embarrassing way my dungeon master could have died. Let's move on. We have a lot of money. I don't think we need to buy any minions. We're kind of doing well on minions, to be honest. So maybe we go ahead and hit the engineer and upgrade a trap here. And then we can do a plunder. Oh, and then a course. Okay. So engineer. What are we enjoying? I'm enjoying the cactus. That's more thorns and more morale. So I think we want to upgrade that. And then do we want more poison? Longer nature weakness and more damage. That's probably better than this one, if I had to guess. This one costs more. Just a little bit surprised by that. I think I like this one more. Nature weakness is very, very good in this dungeon, so let's grab that one. And we'll save a bit of cash, just in case. So let's head on over to this plunder. We have these three volunteers. Now, we don't really want to lose this one, but I don't care too much if one of these two ends up injured, so hopefully it's not Visago here. So we have a feudal castle. We can get some motivation and some gold. We've got a tavern. It costs us money. We get motivation and we find a monster, but they're all injured from fighting in the disreputable tavern. Or we go to the... Oh my god, that's a lot of gold. But somebody might get injured for 10 weeks, which is probably the rest of the mission. I say we do it. Go! No, it's Visago. We got a lot of money for it. Oh, no. I'm sorry. He's probably out for the whole mission. Oh, no. Edward. Okay. Let's take a course. This guy, do you want to level up twice? Sure. Alchemist. We don't have a lot of tiers to convert, so let's just do an event. Lost adventurer, while wandering around in the corridors this morning, you come face to face with a human. He seems as surprised as you are. What are you going to do? Let's capture him. I always like the money. And now we've got some veterans, or two different groups of veterans here. Disaster room, and we can get a monster or a master bonus. I think we'll go with the master bonus. So let's just double check our monster loadout here. You can go get some motivation. You can come back. Probably do like both thorns in this room. Maybe we'll send our elemental over here so it can synergize. No, actually this one will synergize well with these ones, I think. No, this one, just this one. Yeah, I think we leave these three here. I think that'll be fine. So let's hit these adventurers. Okay, we have level 7, 6, and 6 here. We have a Templar, Elvire, prevents monsters from coming back to life, doesn't matter to us, fortunately. Replaces one of her penalties with a bonus once, and does vulnerable, which is a bit of a problem. We've got Randy, the Virtuoso, does bleeding, AoE damage. Applies dodge to someone. Damage and morale taken from traps is reduced. Okay. And we have the Hellbringer. Dodges the first trap. Applies broken armor when attacking and hits everybody. So that's going to be a bit of a problem. But only this one's doing physical damage. Ooh, but it's 40 resistance. So that's 40% more damage. That is actually kind of bad. Especially because the bleeding's affected by that. Okay. So we have air in the front. Anybody have good air resistance? Ah, the wind elemental, obviously. Ice in the back. That'll be giggy. And then who do we want in the middle? Maybe this one. I do like this minion. Okay, place our monster. So we have air in the front and ice in the back. So probably go ahead and slap this one in the back. Air in the front, but it's a lot. Yeah, this person will die in one hit. No. 120 health? I think it'll be okay. Wait. We could do like this. Okay. Now, unfortunately, he's slower.
than the fire one, so that's unfortunate, but I think I want to try it anyway. And then we've got Trap Disaster Room, Trap Master. That sucks, actually. So let's do, oh boy. Nature and Nature Weakness. So maybe we hit him with Nature Damage and Nature Weakness, give them more Nature Weakness. Then we hit him with the Poison and the Nature Damage here. And then our Master will have a long time to deal tons of extra Nature Damage. And that's good because we heal off of that one back attack. So we'll do extra damage and heal extra from that. So we'll accept that.
I'm waiting for you.
So what do we want to start with? Elemental Weakness. We are going to be doing a lot of air damage, AoE. So maybe Magical Brambles. Tiredness is really good. Oh yeah, applies demoralize at the start of each turn. Cool. So we can do an area, morale, and air damage. That might be good. We might be able to get some of these down to a minus threshold of morale. This one doesn't do a ton. Bleeding's okay. Let's do the nightmare. We might be able to get some morale damage done in here. I did wait, what happened? It did like no damage. Did you dodge? Wait. What happened there? That's interesting. Zephyr Air Weakness. This does air and morale. Lowering their health is also fine because we can use this here to do a bunch of morale damage based on the amount of health they're missing. So doing like hybrid damage here is actually not too bad. It'll set them up to have lowish health and lowish morale for the remainder of the dungeon. So I'm pretty good with that. You do like no damage. Oh, 100% air resistance right now. Oh my god. That's amazing. Vulnerable 2. That might. No, this is gonna do morale damage. So do we wanna do. Okay, only one is slower. So let's just hit him with the Zephyr. Oh yeah, that's pretty good amount of morale damage to the front and the back, and then the middle one is pretty screwed from this. Wow, what a great spell. Super fun. So now we can do a buttload of extra damage to this one. Probably, how much extra? 75 extra damage. Oh, he's hurting himself on the thorns, taking even more damage. That's why he's taking chunks of 35 instead of 20. That's really cool. Applies air weakness, applies burn. Yeah, we want to do that one so that this one does more damage. He destroyed himself, excellent. Okay, we can finally use this. What does it do? It gains thorns, 2 if the target's affected by burn. Excellent. Oh my god, that's a lot of thorns. They are not gonna like hitting this one now. I cannot believe how many stacks of thorns. That's ridiculous. Damage deal is doubled if they're affected by burn. Yeah, let's go ahead and do it. This one cycles through the different elements to do increased damage. She's having a rough time right now. Ooh. Oh no, he's gonna die. Tiredness 7. This is gonna be kind of a slow battle here. Her hurting herself on these, I guess. Actually, this might kill her. Yeah, I don't know how much that was, but it was gonna be a lot. 25 stacks of thorns. Magical Brambles is a good spell. Life Absorption is good, but it only goes up by 8 points. That's only 8 more damage and 4 more health. That's not significant. Power 10 seems like a better... like 10% more damage on any attack we use, especially because that front one would do an extra 10 damage. Yeah, power... it's either... it's one of these two. Maybe just power, just in case they get to us again like they did in the last episode or two episodes ago. Motivation changes from the dungeon. We should hit the trainer with our monsters. Now, who's being very useful? This one's very useful. Doesn't get more health, but let's train Gigi. Let's train this one. It's a very expensive one because he's rare, but that's a powerful monster. Yeah, therapist. Do we want the therapist? You don't... well... no, we're okay. We're okay to go on with just 3 and 3, I think. While people are recuperating. So let's just hit an event. Maybe we can get some money. This is the giant worm again. We'll go ahead and sell that. Alchemist, I don't have enough tears, so I could convert blood into tears and then blood and tears into gold. Maybe we should do that. So let's go ahead and turn some blood into tears. And then let's turn some blood and tears into gold. A business trip. I love business trips. Are we going to have more creatures? Yes, we are. So we can afford to send somebody away on a business trip. This is the most money. Lots of blood. What's this artifact? Fang of Melinda. Demons' attacks regenerate their life by 150% of the damage dealt if the target's affected by burn. Well, we don't have a whole lot of burn. We have one burn can be affected by this character. Here's one. That's really it. So I don't think this is the item for us. So let's go ahead and just get the maximum amount of money, which means we do need to send a character in here, and I think that'll be fine. I think the only issue is that this character is kind of bad without other sources of status effects and damage. Burn, frostbite, or air resistance. Yeah, not very good. So let's put our poison babies together with our earth friend, and then we'll put these three together, and they'll just do what they can. Are we feeling confident about a champion? We have full health, but I think we had pretty close to full last time when we died to a champion. This is the week that killed us last time. It's difficulty 5. There's a resting room for health, which is unfortunate because we're going to be doing a lot of health damage, really. We get a rare and gold after veterans, artifact, or master bonus, and some gold. I think we try the champion anyway, because why not? If I die fighting this champion, I'll just... pause and come back when I'm like closer to this than I am, because I don't want to play through the whole thing again if I fail here. Who's the champion? Uh-oh, Pyromancer. We have a whole group of trees back here. Oh, crap. That's not good. Yep, they're all weak to fire. Okay, we got to deal with this guy first. So, what are we going to do? This does damage to the back, fire, and air. Uh-oh, that's not going to be effective. Enchanted seeds, elemental weakness. Yeah, so maybe we do thorns, the next group of monsters. Let's do poisonous plant, elemental weakness. So then they'll have two forms of weakness to nature. Then we hit them with this one to poison and do some nature damage. Then they heal, unfortunately. I'm going to do ice in the front, physical in the front, fire in the back. Ice and physical in the front. I mean, you just don't have any health. I think it has to be you. And ice in the back. Yeah, that'll have to do. Upgraded spell. Hopefully we can do some good morale damage. By this point, maybe they'll have taken some damage. The front character is going to die. I think they're all going to die, actually. I'm sorry, everybody. It's probably going to come down to the master. Almost for sure, Sarah will be involved. This pyromancer is going to rip through some of these creatures. Okay, so I think we want elemental weakness here. So let's queue him up for a big hit from this trap. Okay, that's pretty good. Plus two stacks of poison. Ooh, almost full heal. But they've got another tick of poison on him. A little bit of weakness still. Immune. Can't be affected by demoralized. Applies bleeding. Does air damage. I don't know here. Air. These two are weak to air. So do a little morale damage, but so much morale on this character. It might just not be possible. Maybe we just need to start trying to take him down. At least we can do ice damage to Moriador here with our master. What happened? He dodged? That was weird. Okay. Temporal. Oh, we've got that troll beer, so you have double health. I keep forgetting about that. Air damage deals 10% of the target's current morale if the target is slower than the Time Watcher. Who is slower? These two. That's not bad. That's a fair amount of morale damage. They're not affected by frostbite. They don't... Oh, air resistance is negative? That's only one of them, unfortunately. This applies burn. Let's do that one, and then we'll start with the cycle of elements here. They're almost at the next tier. Okay, good. They're going to go down. There we go. They're going to take a little bit more damage now, which is good. Keep that down if we can. Thunderstorm does double damage if they're, yeah, affected by burn. We'll hit them with this one. Give them air weakness for our Time Watcher. Uh-oh. Oh. Please survive. Survive! Yes! Okay. I'll keep that morale down. It'll get a little bit back from that, unfortunately. Okay, here's our chance to do pretty big morale damage. Okay, that'll make the front one run away and make this one very low. and therefore take either tons of damage, or we could skip. Because it chained. Yes, okay, we're down to just the Pyromancer, who's obviously the strongest one, but we can do this. We can do this now that we just have one target. Poison leaves is not going to be the right one. So nature damage and nature weakness. Nature damage, nature weakness. And tiredness. Ooh, that's going to be helpful. This butthole heals up every time he uses that. He's healing so much from this. We may not get... We have to go to the master, I think. At least we can stack up a lot of tiredness stacks. He won't be able to do anything. He's staying around the same health. His nature resistance is never going to recover, though. Last attack, then we go to the master, but we're gonna hit him hard with nature and ice.
Oh, did you lose your friends?
Okay, here we go. Frozen Rose. Oh yeah, that's gonna hit pretty hard.
That must hurt.
Except we're weak to fire. Alright, kill him! Oh, his fire went out. Cool. Okay, oh, Chewbacca. Winged boots. Monsters placed at the front gain 40 speed. We have some things that work with that, don't we? Like the Time Watcher? But I love this one. Oh, it has that super cool area of effect attack. It's air damage, too, and we have a lot of effects for that. Ooh, I might have to take the Jabako. Lure, multi-action, the next regular trap. Nah, let's take the Jabako. Always good. Solid creature just by himself. Doctor we don't need, so we'll go to the trainer. Let's see who needs to go. We'll leave them out because I think they're only involved in events if they're in the employee room and not in the garrison. Oops, I missed this air elemental. Okay, so let's go to the trainer. Where's our Jabako? Yes, love the Jabako. I think we'll level up this one with the demoralization. Yeah, get some health. Yeah, okay, let's level that one up. Cool. Starting to like the gargoyle. Alchemist, we could get a little bit of money, but I think we save these for events. Let's hit an event. The Collector. An enthusiast has tracked an artifact to you and would like to buy it for a very attractive price. He seems to carry other similar objects on his person. One of your employees would be able to steal one from him without noticing. I don't want to give up thorns. That's just free damage, and I have tons of elementals. Let's steal from him. Hopefully that doesn't come back to bite me. Event. Strike. Some of your employees are on strike. They demand hazard pay and are threatening to carry on for 4 weeks if they don't get what they want. One of your employees could infiltrate the movement and convince them to reduce their strike to 2 weeks. I don't have an ice elemental. I don't have enough money, so I'm going to refuse. These two... You two are not the ones that should be going on strike. Ritual. So we can upgrade this to level 3, 2% per of morale loss per missing life. That's awesome. That is awesome. So if they're at 50% life and 100% morale, they flee from this. That's really cool. And this will do tons of damage in the back and tiredness. Let's take that one just in case. Engineer event. Journeyman trainer. By chance, you meet a tamer traveling through the region and looking for some work. This traveler offers to train one of your employees at half price. If you have the right employee in your employ, you could even negotiate for him to work for free. Well, I don't have any money and I don't have a Naga, so we're going to have to refuse. Seminar. Or plunder. We do have enough people that we could afford someone to get injured in a plunder. So let's do a plunder. We can do a castle, get some motivation. But we gain two motivation. So even if somebody gets injured, that's actually pretty sweet. Guarded prison, we have a chance to set a monster free, get a little bit of morale. Gold, pay gold, get a monster. So let's do this one here. Get some gold, get some motivation, and then possibly get an injury for only 3 weeks. That's not too bad. Let's do that. Employee injured. That's okay. We got a little bit of gold, some motivation. We have a lot of minions available. Can't afford a course, so let's go to the trainer. Let's upgrade this one. And then we have an event and a plunder. Oh my god, it keeps going after this. Wow, this is a long one. We have a plunder and we have an event, so I guess we do the plunder. Gold mine, tons of gold. Set a monster free. Motivation. Well, we could use the motivation, but we have a lot of minions right now, so we can afford to have some people sitting out, especially if they're already demotivated. They're not going to be going next anyway, so let's just do the gold mine. Okay, we got a 10-week injury on this Treant. That's okay. Treant's not imperative to our plans here. So let's plan for our veterans here. We have either a resting room or a disaster. That one has an artifact, but we don't need an artifact. Master bonus and more gold, plus a resting room. So this one will be harder, but I think the rewards are better for us here. Now we do have this protean barrel, so we can only place one trap right now. So that's okay, because some of these are quite good. Like this one can be very powerful, doing 12 stacks of nature weakness. That's a long time for them to take extra nature damage. Okay, so some people need to go home and recuperate for a bit. No reason to put everybody who needs time can just sit out right now. We've got plenty of full motivation monsters. So we want to put all of our fire boys together over here. Eduard, Vasago, and Adroa. And we want our Jabako Ukan, our Dark Magus Nylra, our Wind Elemental Volus, and our Treant Ponthus. That was a name dump there. We're going to put them all like this so that we have sort of fodder in the front. Sorry, guys, but motivation damage here. And then we'll have our fire synergies back here. Okay, so we're ready to move on to these veterans here. Okay, we have a 8. Ooh, level 8s. Can't be affected by poison. Okay. Possibly a problem? Not as much as usual. I was not hinging on having a poison-themed dungeon. So we can work around that. This character is weak to ice, so we're going to blast the shit out of him with this spell here. 165 ice damage, plus 25% more of that. So that's going to be, you know, almost 200 damage. That's a third of her health, so that's going to be great. This skill removes all penalties. Oh, when she heals after a fight once. Okay, not too bad. This character gives morale back, can't be affected by poison. Annoying. This shuts down all of our fun. Eleanor the Templar replaces a penalty at the start of one of her turns once. All resistances increase by 15. Wow. Wow, look at that air resistance, 80, and ice of 50. Dang. So, now unfortunately, that means after a fight, the start of her turn one. So if I double active this plant, the Templar will just remove all of the nature weakness, unfortunately. But there's no reason to do the poison because this character is immune to it, and this character would remove the poison. Thorns and a little bit of morale damage. Not really what we're going to want here. Although it would be Thorn 6. It would be Thorn 6, wouldn't it? Maybe we do the cactus. And this doesn't... There's nothing to not apply. Like, there's no poison. There's no penalty. No penalty. Yeah. Okay. Got a portrait of a vampire up here. Okay, so we have air in the front, air in the back. does tiredness. So, but you're really here to do the air weakness, I think. Yeah, so you don't, it's okay if you're the one that's getting tiredness stacks. Front is going to get the extra damage. It's probably going to be Jabako because it's going to get double health. Or 50% more health? Yeah, 50% more health from the troll beer. And then we'll put this character in the middle. We've got lots of air damage, lots of morale effects here. So that'll work pretty well. Can't place a trap here. Minotaur statue, I love that. Air in the front. It's going to be Visago, our mega tank. The back is going to be taking air as well. Oh boy, it's going to have to be you. And you in the middle. This is where they're going to rest for some morale. Yep. Second spell. It's a weird spot for it. Okay, so do we want to hit... Now, this one sucks. This one doesn't do anything here because they haven't taken any damage, so we have to use the freeze. But I'm pretty happy with that amount of damage. 206 damage. Okay, cool, cool. So I think we hit them with the tiredness first. That'll reduce the damage we take, which will help us last a little longer. Air weakness. Sinister Roots does nature damage and morale, demoralized. This does air damage and morale, flat morale. Damage dealt increased by 150% of the targets affected by demoralized. Well, demoralized 3. I think we have time to use this one and then this one. So let's try that. She's just struggling already, this shaman back here. So they still have air weakness for one turn, except for this character. So let's keep the air weakness up. We're gonna do air damage with all three of these now, so we're gonna make sure they have that. Okay, Crow Swarm. Oh yeah, wow, she has 17 health. Morale. 150% if they're affected by demoralized. Why are you doing so little damage? You just don't do a lot of damage. Oh, does the morale damage go up too? I think it did. Cool. Stacking up the tiredness is not a waste because we actually skip the next room and go right to monsters. So if they're not going to do as much damage to these monsters, that's good for us. Let's keep that air weakness up. Guy's trying to kill a wind elemental with lightning strikes. Uh-oh, no. Please live. No. Vulnerable in the front. We're almost there. They're gonna get morale back from this, unfortunately, but... Oh, he got a lot of morale back. That's right, he's got that skill. Dang. They're still affected by tiredness stacks. Quite a lot of them. Excellent. Burning spikes. Okay, so we gotta set him on fire. Oh, we gotta get his fire weakness down. Who are you going to affect with this skill? If it does center, but there's probably still this one, I guess. I guess that maybe that was a dumb question. Applies terrified if the target's armor is negative. Well, that only affects the one in the back, but it would give us a new threshold. Flame strike, physical damage, and morale, and burn. Yeah. Whoa. Just Iron Man blasted energy out of his chest. If they get through these two, they're going to have a horrible time fighting. This is going to be just completely covered in thorns. This team is fun. Shadowfit, what are you doing at the start of your turn? Oh. Okay, wow. Just random penalties. Oh my god, why is this... This is so fun. This possessed armor is so fun. Level 2's got 120 health. That's pretty good. His resistances are... Okay, he's got tons of armor. Decent fire, but everything else is kind of bad. But that passive is so cool. And his attacks do like 3-4 different things. It's really neat. All right, let's just punch her. What? He just shot his fist at her. All right, burn her down. Okay, we successfully protected the treasure. 30 blood, no tears, 181 gold. And then we get a master upgrade. We can either do Enchanted Brambles, Blight. We don't really ever do this one. It's not, doesn't seem very good. Resistances plus 5. Let's do the resistances. Okay, motivation changes. That's just all over the place. So, okay, so I think we're going to call this episode to a close here. This was a really fun one. Thank you, everybody, so much for watching. Please consider liking and subscribing. And I will see you in the next episode. We might be able to finish up this mission, and then we'll get ready to start mission 5. So I'll see you then.